His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn His face toward you and give you peace. The Lord bless you and keep you. Make His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn His face toward you and give you peace. Amen. Shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn His face toward you and give you peace. So we receive, we agree. Amen.
Favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family and your children and their children and their children. May His favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family and your children and their children and their children. May His favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family and your children and their children and their children. May His favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family and your children and their children and their children. May His presence go.
before, behind, beside, all around you, within you. He is in me, he is in me. In the morning, in the evening, in your coming, in your going. You're rejoicing, he is for you. May the favor, may the favor.
generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May his favor be upon you, and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May his favor be upon you, and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children.
Romans chapter 8, verse 38 and 39. I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. May the Lord bless the reading of his holy words. I want to welcome you on behalf of the Oluyede and the Farodoye families, and on behalf of our senior pastor here, Pastor Matthew Ashimolo, and our resident pastor, Pastor Yemisi Ashimolo, as well as the resident pastor here, who is our host at KICC Hill Street, Land of Wonders, Pastor Toby Ashimolo and his lovely wife, Sister Toy. I welcome all of you here physically present at the venue today, and those of you joining us online virtually across the globe to this funeral service of our dear sister, Mopilola Stella Olabimpe Aduni Oluyede Ni Farodoye. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we commit today's proceedings into your hand. Holy Spirit, we ask you to move in this place today. Touch your children. Give us strength at this time. In all of this, we say, Lord, let your will be done. Let your grace be manifest. Holy Spirit, come and strengthen us. Come and fill us with your compassion and your uncommon peace as we go through today. In the mighty name of Jesus. So shall it be. In Jesus' name, amen. Can I ask us to remain standing, and we'll take the first hymn. The first hymn, Christ Alone, Cornerstone. Savior's love through the storm. Praise the Lord. Please be seated. Please be seated. We will now move on to the first Bible reading. First Bible reading. And that's going to be the book of Romans, chapter 8, verse 35 to 39. And it'll be read by our sister Cynthia Mamseri, representing the ushers department. Please make her feel welcome as she comes. Praise the Lord.
Thank you, sir. Good morning. Romans 8, 35 to 39. Who could ever divorce us from the endless love of God's anointed one? Absolutely no one. For nothing in the universe has the power to diminish his love towards us. Troubles, pressures, and problems are unable to come between us and heaven's love. What about persecutions, deprivations, dangers, and death threats? No, they are all impotent to hinder omnipotent love. Even though it is written, all day long, we face death threats for your sake, God. We are conceded to be nothing more than sheep to be slaughtered. Yet, even in the midst of all these things, we triumph over them all. For God has made us to be more than conquerors, and his demonstrated love is a glorious victory over everything. So now I leave with the confidence that there is nothing in the universe with the power to separate us from God's love. I'm convinced that his love will triumph over death, life's trouble, fallen angels, the dark rulers in the heavens. There is nothing in our present or future circumstances that can weaken his love. There is no power above us or beneath us, no power that could ever be found in the universe that can distance us from God's passionate love, which is lavished upon us through our Lord Jesus, the Anointed One. Thank you. God bless his reading.
Praise the Lord. May the Lord bless the reading of his holy words. Sister Cynthia. The next item is going to be the reading of the biography, and that will be done by Tola Fadipe. Tola Fadipe, please make him feel welcome as he comes to the stage.
Still in the celebration of our dear sister, I have the privilege to go through the biography. This was a life devoted to family, the church, and humanity. So please come along with me. Sister Amopilola Stella Olabimpe Adoni Oluyede, fondly called Mope, was an extraordinary woman, irreplaceable, a loving mother, wife, sister, and friend who will be forever missed. Sister Amopilola was born to late Mr. Abraham Oladiran Farodoye and Mrs. Stella Morayo Farodoye ni Alokolaro on the 24th of June, 1970 in London, United Kingdom. The family relocated to Nigeria when she was 5 years old and spent her early years in Nigeria, attending Our Lady of Apostle Primary School and Akoka High School in Lagos. She later went to Methodist High School for her A-levels. After her successful A-levels results, she proceeded to University of Lagos, Nigeria, where she graduated in 1994 with a Bachelor's of Arts Honors in English. After her degree, Sister Mokwe went for her National Youth Service Corps service at the First Bank of Nigeria, Sabo Yaba, Lagos. Immediately after her youth service, she gained full-time employment as a program manager and newscaster with MITV Nigeria. She served God from her youth and was an active member of her local church, the Redeemed Evangelical Mission, Trem Akoka branch, where she met Mr. Mayawa Oluyede, and they got married on the 14th of November, 1998. They welcomed their first child, Oluwatobiloba, in November 1999. Shortly after this, in December 2000, they both relocated to the United Kingdom. Getting settled in the UK was not easy, but God saw them through. Sister Mokpelola gained employment as a civil servant at the Department of Trade and Industry in late 2001. They had their second child, a boy, now a man, named Oluwatimileyin, a man, 2002. Sister Mokpelola enjoyed being a civil servant, and this was her career till the end, serving in many different departments over the years as a paralegal, her final department being the insolvency services of the service. Reading was a huge passion for Sister Mokpelola. Any downtime she had, you often find a book in her hand, and that had been a source of her enjoyment since childhood. In line with this passion, Sister Mokpelola published her first children book, Baby Is Sad, in 2017. The first and only of her books that she published, although many were ready for publishing, as mentioned by the husband yesterday, we also heard that Baby Is Happy will be coming. A virtuous woman after God's heart that attended KICC for almost 20 years, before her passing, she was a devoted and committed member of the Ushering and Evangelism Department. All will remember her for her infectious smile, welcoming them to every church service as an usher. Sister Mokpelola was charitable, loving, and caring. She was a committed donor to World Vision and sponsored many children for more than 18 years. In partnership with Mr. Mayawa through their foundation, Mayawa Stella Oluyede Foundation sponsored a number of students through universities in Nigeria for the past 6 years. Sister Mokpelola's charitable legacy will be continued to honor her memory. Sadly, Sister Mokpe was diagnosed with acute Philadelphia leukemia in May 2022. She was a soldier and courageously fought the good fight for over 15 months until she was called home to heaven on the 7th of July, 2023. She was one in a million. Her gentle nature, diligence, love for God, and love for her family and friends will never, ever be forgotten. We love you, Sister Mokwe, but God loves you more. Long live Sister Mokpelola Stella, Olabinpe Adunni Oluyede. You are forever in our hearts and mind. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. Thank you. Thank you, sir. God bless you. The Lord is good. And all the time. Let's stand for the second hymn, In Christ Alone.
This
Please be seated. It's time for the second Bible reading, which will be from the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, 14 to 17. And please welcome Brother Muyiwa Banwo, the head of our Peacekeepers Department, as he comes to read the Bible passage. Make him feel welcome, please. Thank you.
The second Bible reading will be taken from the book of 1 Thessalonians, chapter 4, verses 14 to 17. For if we believe that Christ died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Christ will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall ascend from heaven with a shout, with a voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Thank you.
May the Lord bless the reading of his holy words. Amen. Thank you. Praise the Lord. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for tributes. We're going to take some video tributes first. The first will be by our senior pastor, Pastor Matthew, followed by a few video tributes, and then can Stella's colleagues from work please be ready? We'll take your tributes in person after that. Thank you.
Dear Shimalo, taking this time to celebrate our dear sister, Mukwilola Adoni Oluyede. Want to say, Mukwilola, in almost 20 years of being part of KICC, was an awesome, unusual testimony. her life of being such that did not push herself forward, yet served with all her heart in the usher's department, making impact, making a difference, always attentive, always there, always wanting to touch lives, always making a difference. Herself and her husband, the committed workers in KRCC. I also want to take this time to say, I cannot forget the day she stood by the steps in Prayer City, deliberately, so that she'll be able to put her book, Baby Is Sad, in my hands. I remember holding her hands, praying with her, that her book would go around the world. The second close encounter was in the hospital when I had to go and pray with her. For me, the Mokwelola I saw was a woman who was a fighter with a strong desire to live. We have no doubt that she rests in the bosom of the Savior. We have no doubt that she has become a testimony, and we will see her on the other side of the story. We pray for blessing on her children, her husband, and all of the family, that grace will always abound for them. We trust the Lord that out of this passage, out of this death, will come for the resurrection of greater testimonies of both Mokwelola's heritage and the children God has given her. In Jesus' name, amen.
Mokwelola, you have fought a good fight. You have finished your race, and you have kept the faith. I know there's a crown of righteousness waiting for you. It's sad to let you go, but we have to submit to the will of the Father. I know you're in a better place, but it's just really sad to know that you won't walk this way with us anymore. Thank you for being a good friend. You are a good wife, dutiful wife to your husband, a good mother to your children, a faithful steward. You serve the Lord faithfully till the end, always at your post. My gentle giant, my prayer partner, thank you for all you did while you were here. We will miss you. But we know we'll meet again, so it's good night until we meet on the resurrection morning.
Mokwelola Oluyede, I think we've known the Oluyedes for over 30 years now. My husband and the Oluyedes have been family friends way back from Nigeria, Trem Akoka, up to us moving to Trem headquarters after we got married. Sister Mokwe is such an amiable, lovely lady. I'm so glad our paths crossed. Shortly after we moved to the UK, they also moved over. Sister Mokwe, you're a beautiful woman with a lovely heart. We definitely miss you. I remember the first time our paths crossed when you came into Trem Upper Clapton with Toby Loba, you know, and shortly after that you settled down and you joined the ushering department. We both looked after our babies when they were quite young. Then you have to tell me to take care of Timmy. I'll tell you to take care of EJ while I go to minister on the pulpit, and while you're also ushering sometimes. And I'm so grateful that your family has been a blessing to us. Our testimonies can never be completed without you people, you know. Samapu, you are a darling sister. You've got a large heart. You've got a lovely heart. We definitely miss you. We love you. Rest on my sister. God bless you. And God bless the family of the Oluyedes as well. Thank you.
Yeah, when I got the news that Sister Mokwe was gone, I was just really devastated that day. And it came as a shock because she was... she's the last person I would think would leave us now. But then at the end of it all, it's still a celebration of life because she lived a fulfilled life. One of the things I admire most about her is her calmness, but the fact that she's always very calm, even in times of crisis, anytime. And I know that she would be looking over us as an angel, and God would comfort us, a family.
Ayodele Ilelaboye, I'm so grateful to God for the gift of Mopelola. I met her 30 years ago in Chemakoka Church, where we served the Lord. She's a great friend, a great sister. She moved to the UK and a lot of us joined her, her home being the first point of call for most of us. Mope is loving, unpretentious, unassuming, humble, beautiful inside and out, God-fearing. I remember our girls' trip to Europe, Mope, Detola, myself, and Fumi. She kept us in check. We had great fun. We shared with each other, and she made sure we came back home as well. I remember the family gatherings we had in each other's homes, and at Christmas, every Christmas, and we got to love each other, to share with each other, to pray with each other for the new year coming. Brother Mayowa, Toby, Timmy, the Lord be with you and strengthen you through this period. In Jesus' name, and the entire family as well, the Lord be with you. Mokwe lives forever in our hearts. Her memory is forever blessed. Till we meet her again, the Lord be with us all, and God bless us all. In Jesus' name, amen.
This is the tribute to my lovely friend, Mokwe. Mokwe, you have been a very good and loving friend to me. You have stood with me in times when I needed someone to talk to, when I give you a call. You always call, you're always there, always wanting to know what's going on with me. I remember times when we had to go out as virtuous women. You always come to pick me up. We had lovely rides together. And you always share from your heart things that you're going through, things that, you know, your challenges, and you always encourage me. You always look out for me. You took me as a dear sister, and you'd check on me. You would ask me how I'm doing. What more can I say about you that has not been said? And your children, you always talk about them. You always look out for other people, talking about them, saying how much you love them, how much you want to do things, especially back home in Nigeria, your passion to help people. It is my joy to know that you're with God, and you fought a good fight. Despite all the ordeal you went through, you still remain faithful. You were a true soldier in the Lord. All I can say is, heaven has gained another angel. And I'll say to Brother Mayowa and your children, your lovely children, Oluwato, Biloba, and Timileni, that God Almighty will be with them. God will be true to them, and He will not leave them at this time.
Thank you so much, Brother Mayowa, for the opportunity to share a minute video of your beautiful, beautiful wife, Sister Mokwe. Oh my goodness, my memory of her, she's such a, I call her a gentle giant. She's so gentle, so softly spoken. I remember opportunities where, or occasions when we would have like a threesome where I could be standing there with her and another of her friends come in, and maybe because I've traveled or something, and we're talking about perfumes or talking about an event or talking about a program or talking about her work. You know, and she's just softly spoken. She agrees with most of the things you say, and if she doesn't agree, she just expresses her opinion in such a gentle manner. She's just incredibly beautiful. I remember at my birthday party how beautiful she is, and to be honest with you, she's not just beautiful on the outside, she's beautiful on the inside too, and that's my memory of her. I just want to leave something with you that somebody said to me when my auntie passed. And they said that you never get used to them not being around. You just find an easier way of coping with them not being around. And I'll just leave that within. And also, I just want to say the times your heart ached the most, the times you needed the most, the incredible comforter, the Holy Spirit we serve, that he would be there for you somehow. I don't know how, I don't know when, at those times when you have questions and these questions are not being answered, he will be there to comfort you all, you and the children, in Jesus name. Sending you so much love from the bottom of my heart. Love you lots. All the best.
Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. The Lord bless you.
Praise the Lord. Those were very powerful video tributes. So we're going to have some in-person tributes now. Can I invite Stella's colleagues from her workplace to come forward? And Abiola Abiodun to get ready. Please encourage them as they come. These are Stella's colleagues.
We knew this person just as Stella, so we're going to talk about Stella today. So Stella joined us when I led the team. In fact, I interviewed Stella for the job, and there was absolutely no doubt that she was going to join us because she was amazing. She was a wonderful, caring, and compassionate person. She always saw the very best in all of us, and she certainly kept our moral compass in check. I've looked through the many messages from the Insolvency Service, and the qualities that are mentioned time and again are her calm nature, work ethic, and her unwavering faith. She will be very... She will be sorely missed, but we were all blessed to have her in our life.
We're all deeply heartbroken for the loss of beautiful Stella. She was a very good friend of mine and to all of us, not just a colleague, for many years. I think I met her when her children were in primary school, so quite a long time. And I'll never forget her. Kind and patient, no task was too much. Her faith and her prayers got me through many troubles, and for that I'll always be grateful. I will never forget her beautiful smile and infectious laugh, often telling me off for any choice words or negativity. She certainly kept us positive, and that's how she'll be remembered by all of her colleagues, a positive light shining on all of us. God bless and rest in eternal peace, our dear friend.
Please. Go on, please.
I had the pleasure of working with Stella in 2015 when I first met her. Her smile lit up our room in team meetings. Her laughter was infectious, and she was a precious and kind soul. So may she rest in peace, and my condolences to the family as well. Thank you.
Thank you. Just a quick announcement before we go to the next tribute. Hopefully you would have seen the signs outside that there's a requirement to pay for parking. If you haven't done so, please make sure that you pay for parking. If you have the Pay by Phone app, you can use that. and just search for the Stanley Road car park. Praise the Lord. And also before we go on, I'd also like to just acknowledge our pastors in the house. Pastor Yemisi Ashimolo, our resident pastor, is in the house. You're welcome, ma'am. And for those of us who were here yesterday, we would have witnessed the Akoka family in full display. And here today with us again, Pastor Akintola Oni from the Redeemed Evangelical Mission, TREM, Akoka. You're welcome, sir. God bless you. And we also know there are quite a number of pastors in the house, so we celebrate. Please give a round of applause to all pastors in the house. Praise the Lord. We'll now move on to the next tribute, and that will be from Abiola Abiodun. Abiola Abiodun, please step forward. Give him a round of applause, please, as he comes. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. It is really, really a painful thing for me personally to be here, because why, I got to know Mokwe 42 years ago. That was when we were admitted into the same secondary school. And especially and uniquely, we became friends from the very first day. And that was because both of us, myself and her, we had the same, then we call school mother. So we had a very special bond. We had a very unique bond. It's been said several times that she was a very loving person. She was also a very beautiful person. Very beautiful inside and out. And I remember back in the days when we used to have inter-house sport, and we would compete amongst houses within the school. She was always selected as the queen of her house. So she stood out. You couldn't miss her. She was brilliant academically. She was articulate all around. So she was an individual that was a go-to person when others had challenges in school. So personally, it's very painful because why, I think it was just a little over 2 years ago that Koshala told me that, oh, she came across her. And we had not seen since we left school 1986. So I was eager and I had looked forward. So when he told me, oh, he saw her, I think it was at a Unilag get-together thing. I said, did you collect her number? And he said, no. I said, why now? So we had been looking forward to the opportunity. So when this news came in July, it was really, really heartbreaking. Not just for me personally, I can say the same for our colleagues in Akoka. Most of them are still chatting, even as I'm here. And so many are expressing their sadness, their sorrow. So many that were looking forward to a time we will have the opportunity to get a reunion, a get together. But we thank God for the life she has lived. I thank God for the testimony that has been given about her stewardship here on earth. More importantly, about our relationship with our Maker. It is very heartwarming to see our lovely husband, the children. So we can see a uniqueness of our family base. I remember back then on Akoka Road, Fimbers Road, we call it then. We used to go to our house, unique family, welcoming. When we leave school, we can walk in, have a lunch before we go to our respective homes. That was how accommodating the family was. So it is very, very painful. Tender age, but at the same time, well lived. So we thank God for our life. It is our prayer, and I say this from the bottom of my heart, on behalf of Akoka 86 Saints, that the Lord will keep you. He will strengthen you. He will comfort you. He will be your strength and your stay. He will not forsake you. The children that she has left behind, the Lord will be with them. He will walk with them. He will not forsake them. Your dream, the dream of your mom for you, by the special grace of God, will be fulfilled. Why? Because the Lord is ever sure. And your mom trusted in the Lord right from our very early age, right from our young age. And I have that assurance because she has gone this early. Like it's been said several times, she's an angel now. The Lord has a way of taking his own very special and very unique ones. So you can be rest assured that your mom was special. Not just special to us here, was more special to God. And that's why she has gone earlier. So he will be with you. He will not forsake you. I want to thank you, my brother. I wish we had had the opportunity to meet on a more pleasant note. But you can be rest assured, Akoka 86 said, if you need anything, if you want anything, please call on us. We're ever ready and we'll support you all the way. May the Lord bless you. Thank you all for joining.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Akoka was a real central location in the life of our sister because she also went to a university in Akoka, the best university in Nigeria, University of Lagos. Great Akokites. Yes, I am holding the mic, so praise the Lord. The Lord is good. And there is so much outpouring of love for her, on our alumni WhatsApp group. You know, I've never seen it. And what you sow is what you see. That what you when you sow things, that's what you reap. This gentleman, Brother Mayowa, was probably responsible for me joining that group, and quite a number of us, and the outpouring of love for him and for our sister Mokwe. The Lord is good. Are you ready for the word now? I think it's a time that we need the word. Please welcome Pastor Dikpo Oluyomi.
Praise the Lord. Just to correct that the best university in Nigeria I need to correct that. Yeah. So that's the UI of Lagos. Amen. Praise God. Well, it's great to see that we are all, despite what has happened, still able to laugh and to celebrate, because this indeed is just a celebration of the life of our sister. I want us to pray. Father, we thank you. I pray that the entrance of your word will bring light and life. Let nobody live here, and those who are listening right now online, let them not leave those platforms the way they came there. Reveal yourself to them. Thank you. In Jesus' name. We've heard the glowing tributes to our dear sister, Mopelola. And for me, my assignment is to preach to those who are still alive. And I feel that an occasion like this is important to bring us to some understanding. And I will say a few things in the few minutes I've got. And the first thing is to say that life does not end here. Life does not end here. Don't let anybody deceive you that we die and that's it, and we just become sand in the grave and disintegrate. A human being is made of spirit, soul, and body. The body will disintegrate, but the spirit that's in us is the real us. And the one thing that has 100% result in every age and time period is death. Apart from the biblical account of Enoch and Elijah, everybody dies. Even Jesus died. The only thing was that he rose again. Lazarus died. He rose again to die again. And it is so sure that Paul said in Philippians chapter 1, verse 21, he said, "For me to live is Christ, and to die is gain." For me to live is Christ, and to die is gain. What would make a man say that? What makes a person make a statement like that? You only make a statement, I mean, such statements, when your reality lies much in the realm of what is not seen. You make such statements when your reality is anchored in the life beyond. So for Paul, it had become a question of this is life. And so we know that our sister lives on, because God is not the God of the dead. He's the God of the living. Hallelujah. I want us to know that we have an opportunity at this junction to begin to live a life here in this present moment that connects us with the life we want on the other side. In Matthew chapter 22, verse 29 to 33, Matthew 22, verse 29 to 33, This was at a point where a group of people called the Sadducees came to meet Jesus, and they came to accost him with this question because they did not believe in the life after death. What a religion. As opposed to the Pharisees who believed in the life after death. And so they felt they could test Jesus, and they brought this case of a woman who really, I believe, was an hypothetical situation, case. They just said, let's test him with this. She had a husband, the husband passed away, and then the next brother took over, and all the seven brothers married her because they were all dying. Whose wife will she be in the life after? That was their question. And so Jesus answered in Matthew 22, 29 to 33. Jesus answered and said unto them, ye do err, which simply means you are ignorant, not knowing the scriptures, nor the power of God. For in the resurrection they neither marry nor are given in marriage, but are as the angels of God in heaven. But as touching the resurrection of the dead, have ye not read that which was spoken unto you by God, saying, I am the God of Abraham and the God of Isaac and the God of Jacob. God is not the God of the dead, but of the living. Hallelujah. And when the multitude heard this, they were astonished at his doctrine. So we are confident that our sister continues to live, but in a different dimension. He said, I am the God of Abraham and the God of Isaac and the God of Jacob. He's not the God of the dead, but of the living. And if you have any doubt at all, as a Christian maybe, Jesus himself gave us a very clear picture of a life after death in the story of Lazarus and the rich man. Because he did not even say that was a parable. If you read the scriptures, it was not brought forth as a parable. It came across as something that really took place. And the rich man died. Lazarus died, and both of them went to different locations. But in that time, they could see from where they are because Jesus had not risen yet to take everybody to heaven. So they could see from Hades, where the dead are kept, waiting for that time when Jesus will come. One side was hell, the other one was Abraham's bosom. I mean, when you say hell, maybe it's a place of torment. And the rich man was in hell, not because of his riches, always know that, because sometimes people will teach that in the wrong, and that maybe you have to be poor to go to heaven like Lazarus. No. It was based on how they functioned on this earth. And so we read in Luke chapter 16, verse 22 to 23, and it came to pass that the beggar died and was carried by the angels into Abraham's bosom. The rich man also died and was buried, and in hell he lifted up his eyes, being in torment, and seeth Abraham afar off, and Lazarus in his bosom. Just to let you know that what you don't see is more real than what you see. And that's why we walk by faith and not by sight. And the Bible says faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. if your life is totally connected to only what is seen, you have missed it. I repeat that. If your life is only connected with, oh, somebody did this to me, and all the issues of this world, you have missed it. You will not even have a life of joy, a life that's pleasing to God. So we see the rich man right there in hell, and Lazarus in Abraham's bosom. And the torment was real. And that he had to ask Father Abraham, can you send Lazarus? Now, the rich man is still commanding, even in hell, to come and drop some water. Give me some water. A drop of water. A drop, just a drop, will probably give me some relief for a few seconds, because what I'm going through in hell, that's the rich man saying, is tormenting. But Abraham said, there's a chasm. Nobody can cross this. Your life, the life you lived on that side, has determined forever your position eternally. And that's why we don't joke with these things. Somebody may joke with it, thinking, oh, these Christians or these people talking about being born again, give your life to Christ, they are all just not facing reality. There is nothing out there. You don't want to die to find out that there is a lot out there. Oh, go. Then he said, oh, can you send some people to go and preach to my people? Because now the rich man is now connected with the reality of what's going on. Send somebody to go and teach or talk to my brothers who are still on earth, that they don't come where I am. And Abraham said, no, they have other people there, Moses and the rest of them. If they don't listen to them, if somebody rose from the dead and came, they won't even listen to. Because it's a question of faith. Hallelujah. Our sister has gone. And I want you to know that it's not always, even though we believe and we stay strong on that, that God wants us to live long. He said, with long life will I satisfy you, and I will show you my salvation. We will never preach anything outside of that. But we know God, in his sovereignty, chooses what he does. Jesus himself lived only 33 years. Paul himself, they were killed. All the apostles were killed apart from John the apostle. And they were men of God who did signs and wonders, who raised the dead and did great things. So it's not always the number of days that you live. It's the life you live and how much you give. And that's why it's so important to commit ourselves to living for God on this side of heaven. Your lifestyle here begins to be informed by the reality of the life you look forward to on the other side. If I'm going to heaven, then I'll start to live like heaven on this side of heaven. Because the kingdom of heaven is not just one location. The Bible says the kingdom of God is within you. So I already must start to live like somebody who knows I belong to the kingdom of heaven now. I must. And through giving my life to Christ, confessing my sins and asking Jesus to come into my heart, I begin to make myself a candidate of heaven. The Bible says, as many as received him, to them he gave power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, those who are born not of the will of man, nor the will of flesh, but born of God. How many are born of God here? Hallelujah. If you are not, you have the opportunity today to do so. You have the opportunity to do so. You see, what happened after Jesus answered the Sadducees from the previous passage I read in Luke 16:22. If you now look at Matthew 22:34-40, Matthew 22:34-40, it says, but when the Pharisees had heard that he had put the Sadducees to silence, they were gathered together. Then one of them, which was a lawyer, asked him a question. Thank God for lawyers. Tempting him and saying, Master, which is the great commandment in the law? Jesus said unto him, because now they want to ask, how do we get there? The Pharisees were asking, how do we get there? We believe in life after death. The Sadducees don't believe. And you've been able to knock their theory about no life after death off. Now we believe. Now tell us. That's what they say. And Jesus is answering. Let me go back to that passage. He said, and Master, which is the great commandment in the law? Jesus said unto him, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, 100%, and all thy soul, and with all thy mind. Not just on Sunday mornings. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, pandemic or no pandemic, and with all thy mind, whether people are there or not. And he goes on. He said, this is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. So, this no doubt will influence how you function on this side of heaven. When you love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul, including your body. And then you love your neighbor as yourself. That means you will never hold your neighbor in bitterness, starting with your husband, your wife, and other people around. Because if you love yourself, you won't hold yourself in that kind of bitterness. Neither will you hurt your brother or your sister. You will not go and cheat them in any form or shape. You won't take what belongs to them because you love yourself and you love your neighbor as yourself. It's a good opportunity, like I said, for us as Christians who are born again to have a reflection and a rethink of how we are functioning on this side of heaven, because this day comes to every man. The only thing that will stop a day like this for every person on this earth right now is when Jesus comes. The trumpet will sound, the Bible says, and the dead in Christ will rise, and we that are living will be caught up to be with the Lord. We long for that day. We long for that day that we won't have to die and we'll just fly away, oh glory. That's the longing of any true child of God. But if Jesus tarries, a day like this is coming to everyone. And we've had very glowing tributes about our sister. Now, we don't function just because we can have glowing tributes. We function because Jesus is already working in us both to will and to do of his own good pleasure. Because you won't even be here to hear most of the tributes. You're gone. Yeah, you may be hearing from the other side, but you are in the presence of the one that you love, Jesus. So it doesn't matter what even anybody says. Hallelujah. And that's what should inform our living, our functioning on this side. Today is not a day to preach and preach. So let's stand to our feet. Thank you, Jesus. I want us to say this prayer for those who may be watching online and for those who are here who have not given their lives to Christ. I won't zero in on you as a person, but everybody is going to say this prayer of committing their life to Christ just to support you if you are doing so and you need to. Say, Lord Jesus, forgive me my sin. I thank you for shedding your blood and dying on the cross for me. I ask you to come into my heart. Come and live there. Come and reign there. Satan, you are not my master. Jesus is my master. Jesus is my Lord. From today, I will serve him with my spirit, my soul, and my body. Thank you. In Jesus' name. Father, for those who have said that prayer meaningfully, from today, you draw them in and they become pillars in your house, never to go out. And for them to continue to live for you by the power of the Holy Spirit. Thank you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Whilst we're still standing, I'll please ask that my dear brother and the children, please come forward. And other family members that feel want to join them, please do so. We want to pray for them. Hallelujah. Are you coming? Yeah, come. Thank you, Father. I want us to stretch our hands towards them. Like our senior pastor was saying in his video tribute, that this will be a resurrection into new things, glorious things, in the name of Jesus. Just begin to pray for them. 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 Just begin to pray for them. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Mashita kaile boshikata. Reba rabasakata. Rebobo sataya labashikata. Rebando sikata yalabas. Mate karabande lebo shikata yalab. In Jesus' name. Father, thank you for our brother and the children. We give you praise and glory. From today, a new season. Holy Spirit, let your comfort be with them. Let your strength be with them. Show them things to come. Father, I pray that, Lord, they will go forward beyond the legacy that our sister has left and do greater things, mightier things, powerful things, things that will bring glory to your name, honor to your name. We cover them with the blood of Jesus. We cover the whole family with the blood of Jesus. And we say concerning them, no evil shall befall them. No plague will come near their dwelling. You will give your angels charge over them to keep them in all their ways. They will not dash their foot against a stone, because you will keep Israel. You neither slumber nor sleep. Father, they will go forward, never backwards. Forward ever, never backwards. Every root of any spirit of death, we command, go in the name of Jesus. You will live and not die. I said you will live and not die. Every fear, every root of fear is uprooted in the name of Jesus. We command a new day, a new beginning, a new day, a new beginning, a new day, a new beginning. In the name of Jesus. Thank you. The children will rise to become notable people. Notable people. Notable people. In the name of Jesus. Thank you. We give you all the glory. We give you the praise. Thank you for all the family. Thank you for the friends. Bless them. That from this day forward, fresh things, new things, glorious things. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Be with them. Show them things to come. Walk alongside them. Teach them things they don't even know about yet. Thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Praise the Lord. Let's give God praise.
Praise the Lord. Please be seated. Let's appreciate the ministry of Pastor Deepo. The Lord is good. And all the time. Just a few announcements the address, the cemetery address for the internment service is in the funeral booklet. It's the Chase, Dagenham Road, Rush Green, Dagenham RM107DR. So it's there on page at the back, I think. Yeah, at the back page. And after that, the family would also be happy to see those that can join them for a short reception at KICC Romford, 1 Carlisle Road, Romford, Essex, RM1 2QP, 2QP, not QL, QP. We will now take a vote of thanks from our dear brother, Brother Mayowa. Please welcome him as he comes. Praise the Lord.
Good morning, church. This is the day the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. First and foremost, I want to thank the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Ancient of Days, the Giver of Life. The God that woke me up this morning, the God that woke you up this morning. We've made a strong commitment as a family that nothing shall take us away from the love of Christ. We will serve God to the very end. Mokilala Dunimi's last word was, "Thank you, Jesus." And that gave me a challenge. I was sharing with the children. I said, look, she's run a race, and she has finished well. Now we have to run our own race. Without shadow of doubt, we know where she is. We know where she is. Every blessed day, not fail, there's a routine of our service to God. And our life actually brought a transformation to my life. Our life was a life of testimony. She'll be forever missed. But I know that our spirit is with us. She's our angel now. I want to thank the bishop of this house, our pastor, Pastor Matthew Ashimolo, Pastor Yemisi, and the entire pastoral team. From the bottom of our heart, we say thank you. I want to thank the entire KICC family. You know, I said last night, for me, my favorite scripture in the Bible is they were together in one accord, and there's no lack among them. For me, that is church. Church that is classless, it doesn't matter how rich you are, poor you are, we are together in oneness, glorifying our Father in heaven and affecting lives, changing our world. That is church for me. And I also stress on the fact that relationship is key. Relationship is key. And that's why one we chase 1,000, two we put 10,000 to flight. It's a geometric progression. It's all about relationship. You've all come today is as a result of service and relationship. And I want to thank everybody that's present on a Friday morning to give your last respect. From the bottom of my heart, the entire Faroe family and the Oluyede family, we say thank you all. I want to thank my group, the CMA group. I mixed them out last night. I salute you guys. You rock. Thank you so much. My great Akoka family, great Akoka. The greatest and greatest and greatest and greatest Akokaite. I have the microphone now. I know he's going to get it back. It's the greatest university in Africa. Yes. Not in Nigeria, in Africa. I want to thank the ushering department, the peacekeeping department, the virtuous women, the evangelism department, the branches, the cooking units that Mokulala belongs to. I want to thank friends and families that are here. If I miss you out, forgive me. But I've got few friends and family that they travel from overseas just for this event. Dr. Muneyi, I can see you up at the gallery. Thank you, sir. All the way from Canada, just for this event. That is the seed of relationship. It can easily just say, Mayo, send me your bank account. and wire £500, £1,000, but you know when you fly the first class to come to United Kingdom just for events of one day and go back. It means so much to me. We've known ourselves for the last 35 years, and we'll do great things together, my brother. Thank you. Tola Fadikpe, all the way from Lagos, Nigeria. That's my brother from another mother. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Our path connected, how many years now? You know, we were colleagues in Dia Fatimileyan Co. Little did we know that we're going to become business associates, family friends, and everything from humble beginning. Why am I sharing this? This is what I live for. I'm an encourager. It's not about making money, I'm an encourager. That is my passion, that is my own office, that's my own calling. I said last night, I said, money will fail, but relationship will take you to a new level. Money is good. It will do so many things. Money can't buy this relationship. There's a scripture in the Bible, the rich man called all his big rich men to come and feast with him, and they didn't show up. The guy was so frustrated, he had to say, go and call the broken heart, just call anybody to come and fellowship with him. So we really, really cherish this relationship. Honestly, from the bottom of my heart. What can I say? My friend from Chicago, Mr. Adeyemo, thank you so much. Where are you? Yeah. Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I think we've known now for over 28 years plus. God bless you. The Akoka family. I'm sure you've been hearing Akoka, 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 Akoka. That's our roots. And you guys shouldn't feel intimidated. It's just where our Christian faith was. That was the foundation. And KICC took it to the next level. It's a great thing to serve the Lord. And if you are in this house, you are here this morning, you've not given your life to Christ, this is an opportunity. It's a great thing to serve the Lord. I've known the Lord since 1992 to date, and he's a good God. He's a good God. Sometimes we don't know, we might not know when he's working, but he's working something. We might not see it. What we see is what we know. Many things we do not see. When the righteous are taken away, sometimes God has a plan. He takes his best. He has a plan. And his plan and purpose for your life, God will bring it to pass for you in Jesus' name. He wants you and I to be a shining light in this world. What can I say about my pastor from Nigeria? Pastor Akintola Oni, thank you so much, sir. I appreciate you. I appreciate you. He had to change his flight. He has holiday booked for end of August or September. And it was so difficult to change. And he just called me 2 days ago and said, I'm at the airport. I'll be joining. I said, really? It just blew my mind because he doesn't have to do that. But it's a relationship that has transcended beyond just being my pastor. You had him last night when he relocated. He had an assignment to work in the UK for almost a year. And so many options. I said to him, no, this man too must be in my house. And I had to hijack the man and said, you have to live with us for one good year. And I know some of those prayers, those days, is some of the things that we're seeing today. Thank you, sir. You are more than just, not just a family, not a brother. You are just a God sent to our life. Every year, he will call myself, my wife, my children. He knows our bad date. not fail, for over 23, 25, 4 years. How he does it, I don't know. So the relationship I preach about, I picked it from you. You might not know. This man is an epitome of relationship. All the Akoka family, I'm sure, is the same truth. Those of you in Canada, in America, everywhere, he will call you at your date of bad day. Call you, call your wife, call your children. Magnetic brain. He doesn't write it anywhere, he just know. And he will call. I convert such grace, sir. Thank you. And who else have I missed from here? I don't want to be fine today. Virtual Usher, Peacekeeper, Branch, and Family, Pastor. Okay, Pastor Esther. Okay. Oh. Thank you, thank you. And let me give a shout to Samuel Igbanjo, a great friend indeed. These guys, Antoya and KOC, they've always been making sure that, have you eaten? What are you doing? Are you okay? In fact, they organize and make sure some friends stay with me every day. Since 7th of July, my house has been like a church. We had to get a canopy tent in my garden, the way people were flowing in. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. And lastly, how can I forget you guys? I've read some of the tributes on the Forever page. Thank you, thank you. The Insolvency Department, we appreciate you all for coming on a Friday like this. And I can see almost 13, 14 people from the workplace. Thank you, thank you. And it's so sad that this is how we actually got to meet ourselves, because last month we'll have been Mokulala. We wanted to celebrate her in a grand style, but it was not meant to be. You know, I wanted, when she turned 50, 3 years ago, she said she doesn't want a party. You had yesterday people calling her Mokwe 2020. That was where we would have celebrated her. Yeah. And that didn't happen, and we wanted to do it last month. But this happened. In November, we'll have been our 25th wedding anniversary. Two events that we were planning to, but God knows best. And we cannot query, we cannot ask him why. In rounding up, I just want to give it to God. He's my maker, he's our maker. There'll be beauty for our ashes. This loss is not just my loss alone. I know how you guys are grieved and pained, but God knows the best. Thank you all for celebrating. Omo ni mopo, omo ajimojo yi, omo ni gbarinla, omo loye meko, olobi mejeje apejeji lala. Sunre.
Praise the Lord. Father, we thank you. El Shaddai, we give you glory. We give you praise. We exalt your holy name. We're getting to the end of this part of the service. But I'm just reminded that the Bible says that in the mouth of two witnesses, scripture is the truth is established. So on this microphone, you've heard two people say one university is the greatest, and one person say another university is the greatest. Selah. Selah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We are going to take the closing prayer now, but as we do so, when we take the closing prayer, and then we take the recessional song, we will go out in a particular order, which will be the front row first. After the gentleman will come to take the coffin and move out that way. And then we just, as the song goes on, we then follow in order based on row by row. Father, let's stand. Let's stand as we take the closing prayer. Father, we thank you. El Shaddai, we give you glory, we give you praise, we exalt your holy name. Thank you for a day like today, because you have strengthened us. You have even made us to even find time to even laugh. Jehovah, we give you glory and praise. We commit the remaining of the proceedings into your hands. We say, Lord, strengthen your children. Many are confounded, but Jehovah, your peace, your uncommon peace that passes human understanding, garrison their heart with it in the mighty name of Jesus. Give us that strength of fortitude to bear this loss. Lord, I pray that even the words that have come and have touched some souls today, to make them to make a decision to have a relationship with you. Jehovah, we pray that these ones will be established in your house in the name of Jesus. Father, we give you glory. We pray for everybody who have come from far and near, that even as they go back to their various destinations after today, journey mercies in the name of Jesus. We pray also, Father, that we will not gather for short life like this again in the mighty name of Jesus. We draw the line. We declare it has to stop in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We give you glory and we give you praise. Father, we thank you in Jesus' name. May the Lord bless you and keep you, protect you, sustain you and guard you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you with favor, and may he be gracious to you, surrounding you with loving kindness. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you with his divine approval, and may he give you uncommon peace as we go. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. And as the gentlemen now move forward, we will now take the closing hymn, which is the song Goodness of God by Bethel Music. Goodness of God by Bethel Music. And we'll have a recessional party, as I described. God bless you all. We thank those who are online as well. We will continue the online transmission when we get to the internment service. God bless you and thank you.
Presence, love before. face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. The Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Amen. 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 Amen.
all around you, within you. He is real, he is real. In the morning, in the evening, in your coming, in your going.
Your rejoicing, he is for you.
He is for you.
May the favor, may the favor.
Amen. 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 Am
favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family and your children and their children and their children. May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family and your children and their children and their children. May his favor.